you wanna put your name on it. Put your name on it. Come and put your name on it. Bip it, bip it,
It's not even my birthday. But he wanna lick the icing off.
The icing off.
I know you want it in the worst way.
The worst way.
Can't wait to blow my candles out. He want that.
What's up, world? It's your boy A.E.D.A.T. coming at you with the what?
Say what again? Say what again? I dare you. I double dare you, motherfucker. Say what one more goddamn time.
All right. The what's what and what? As I come across it. Since I've been gone so long, I forgot to tell you. Happy New Year, motherfuckers. So in case you were under a rock last weekend or on vacation or somewhere or being babysat by Casey Anthony, you missed the party of the semester. Yes, folks. I'm talking about
KAOS.
For those of y'all who missed this party, I don't know what you was thinking. Cause I I'll give it to you because I was a little skeptical at first. I heard the Alphas are throwing another party, and with their little track, you know, with their track record, I'm like,
Yo, fuck that. Let's go the other way.
But they were throwing the party in conjunction with the Sigmas, the Qs, and I think the Kappas, or maybe the Kappas were like, I don't know, just put on there like, hey, Kappas, what's up? Those three, they come together, they throw a party, and it's just everybody from everywhere, from New York, from Florida, to Boston, like from every, I don't know where the fuck these people came from. I'm just saying, from everywhere come around, you got Greek, they had, everybody was in that party. Like, everybody who was everybody who wanted to be and pretended to be everybody was at that party. Because they know it was good. This year, the party was thrown in Clark Gym, which is at RIT. It's a gym. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a big-ass gym. Lots of space, tons of space, just and
oh, and you know the thing about KAOS.
That party was wild. Like, I mean, just
when I roll into the when I stroll into the
knowing what kind of party this was gonna be already, I had to bring out Big Bertha. This is Bertha. Say hey, baby, this is my baby. Come out, we shooting, they had the light going, we was in there, we had to get the shit on film.
Shout out to everybody I fuck with, I'm fucked up, RIT's going down, what's up?
She a fireman, but popcorn are the only man she want, the only man she want, yeah.
She no care if she an him fight, or if him drive the far at the stoplight.
She are the only man she want, the only man she want, yeah.
Man says she very special, yeah,
very special.
Like a la dry line, in all line. So I'm up on the front line, in all line. If we buy her the world in a start, the house and the car. Still she won't give me the thing in the restroom and the bar. Hey, she willing for one pan the pool. Willing to give me anywhere pan the door. All when you must search a bar for one a popcorn a every ringtone. Him go sarang call a horse. Them friends said the relationship poor.
Got in there, it was cool. Space. And then, you know, the people just start coming in. You know, niggas always want to be late, you know. But this episode, we actually have my correspondent, Chloe Williams, in her white girl news anchor voice. Tell them what you were saying. Take it away, Chloe.
Hi, everyone. We are live at the KAOS party. I'm here on campus right now with RIT. Everything's really starting to get going. It's now past inflation, if my time is right. Let me check that. Up 3 minutes before inflation. It's $5 before inflation, $10 after.
First things first, everybody was effed up. Plus 2 points for that. Bleach is pushed back. Plus a point for that. When you have too many being pepped up, and you know how many freshmen was in that joint, and it's like, oh, y'all know freshmen. They don't never know how to hold their liquor. So on top of everybody being effed up, you have people throwing up everywhere. It was gross. Shout out to a girl who got throw up all in her hair. Like, the girl was all up in. I'm like, ugh. Oh, and shout out to the two girls who's walked in the back and walked barefoot, and somebody else threw up in the other girl who slipped in it.
Ew.
Usually a night you can't remember is a good ass night. Kudos to the niggas who was sparking up the L in the middle of the party and just did not get caught by security. Respect. So let's talk about who was in there. Who was, who wasn't, who was. Yeah, the alphas in there. You had the handful of kappas in there. You had the AKAs, the zetas, the betas, the deltas, the Qs, the sigmas, the... That's all a divine name, right? I don't... Plus 2 points to the alphas for rolling deep. Like, I mean deep, like... We could have had it both. Anywho, the party was hype. The music was by DJ Tumbo, who's out of New York City. I want to say Brooklyn, because he just kept going back to where my Brooklyn heads at. And, you know, everybody like, and whatever. Now, let me just jump right into it. The moment of the night. We all know what it is. We all saw it. We... that did that, but I really thought old girl was about to die. I thought her head was just about to go shit. Right on the DJ booth, like, you know. Rule number one, ladies, this is, I'm speaking to my freshmen, because I'm everybody else knows this. If there's a party and there's a stage and they inviting you up on it, know that once you step on that stage, you are getting disrespected. And I mean, I don't mean like, you about to get, you know. No, I mean disrespected. Your ass about to get hit by 9-10. Any hand that is free and within 3 feet of your ass is about to get a feel. Is about to get hit. Your panties probably coming down. You're getting pictures. This shit going to end up on World Star, because... You know, I'm gonna put it there. Like, come on, man. You know, I sometimes wonder what would happen if Maya Angelou was like 20 years old here, and she came to one of these parties. Would she be getting buck wild, or would she still be talking about the cage bird and all he's singing and blah, blah, blah? You know what I'm saying?
Does my sexiness offend you? Oh.
What happened to the phenomenal women? No, I don't want no scrub. The scrub is a guy that can't get no love from me. I mean. That phenomenal ass got phenomenally, I must say. Everybody trying to be a basketball wife. Everybody trying to be a bad girl. You know what? Do you, ma? Do you? Do you, ma? Right? Yep. But, yeah, for real, that moment was the greatest party moment this year that I've been to in Rochester. Like, the greatest Rochester party moment was that moment right there. I just got to run that back one more time. I even got it from a different motherfucking angle. Shout out to Good News. But I'm not going to keep this video too long, because really this footage speaks for itself. I'm going to just hop right into the scoring. Space! I'm going to give it 8. 8 because they was in this gym, and despite what my footage looks like, if you make films, you know that there's a way you can angle the camera to make it look like there are motherfuckers in there. When it's like there's a whole backspace, but I mean, it's a gym. There was still breathing room, so if you got hot in the middle, you can just ease on back in. I don't think anybody else could have really filled up that space the way they did. It takes some balls, to think that you about to rent out a gym and then fill that motherfucker up. So, kudos, man. Affordability. I'm going to give a 9. Because, it's the typical price. 7 for dudes, 5 for women, 3 for Greeks, and inflation 11.30. I mean, you have enough time to get to the pregame. You have enough time to get your ass there. You had enough time to get in. But if you decided to come after like 12, man, it was a massacre outside. It was fighting outside. It was just too many people trying to come into like too much of a space. Like, have you ever tried to put a nickel in a straw? That's what it was like. A whole bunch of niggas trying to pack too much shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, too many trying to get in. You trying to come late. Trying to be fly. Trying to be cool. Unless you had some letters, you weren't getting in that motherfucker quick. So, on to the next. Danceability. But for real, it turned into a reggae party. You know, I had no problem with that. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was all good. But they was killing it in the front. They was getting it in the middle. And then, like, a couple people here and then here. Everybody else was just walking around looking stupid. And just kind of stern and not dancing. You know, you see it. Me, personally, when... Let me break this thing down to you. There's no reason I should be jumping on an ass before you should. You feel what I'm saying? Any other nigga, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you look at a girl, they be like, dig, son, like, yo, look at that nigga, yo, look at that, like, look at that, like, really, nigga? Really, nigga? You just gonna let her sit down and like, what? Fine. But let me tell you this. All you niggas walking around there looking, look at that ass. Like, have you never seen one up close? Is this the first time you've been in 3 inches of an ass? Like, y'all niggas look thirstier than Jamie Foxx in Booty Call. And we all know how thirsty that nigga was for Vivica A. Fox. We all know because we was just as motherfucking thirsty watching that.
You know what? To the right.
You know? Could learn a lot from him, you know that?
I know, but I got this sports cream in this book. You know, I put it on them in and I am ready to go.
But danceability, I'm gonna give y'all a 7. The people in the front / middle saved y'all. Saved y'all. I mean, because personally, y'all couldn't even palance in the right direction. Like, y'all was... He put it on 3-4 different times and y'all still just... Some of y'all was going this, some of y'all was going that way, some of y'all was just... Music! DJ Tumbo. I'm going to give it an 8. You know why, my brother? Because it was cool. The music flowed. It was nice. But you kept fucking me up. You're restarting songs like way too many times. Twice is enough for me. Like, twice. After 3 times, it's like, all right, we ain't resetting no more. You done fucked up the dub. And now I just don't want to do it no more. Fuck it. Just No. Looking like these thirsty niggas. Man, no, I ain't looking at that. I ain't gonna jump on that boot like. That booty is shaking though, you know what I'm saying? Like, dang, son, dang, yourself. Crowd's getting a little pissed off too. They was like, yo, my man, what you doing? 2 times, restart, that's it. Well, unless you like, you jump into it, you restart, do it again, and then you restart again. That's the only other exception, but that's it. Just 2. 1, 2. 1 fish, 2 fish, red fish, blue fish. Overall, I'm going to give this party a whopping 8.5 out of 10. Because that was a good party. I mean, it was a great amount of people. There was a ton of strolling. But it was like strolling with all these different kinds. And you can touch. That was hot looking at the girls. Like, God damn, how can I get the Delta? God damn, what's with them AKAs? And then you making all the women all hot and bothered and trying to take their panties and like, you them girls, like, why you mess with them girls? Why you mess with them? Why you fucking with no girls? Why you fucking? But nah, overall, it was a really good party. It was cool. It was, It was cool. It was fun. It was hype, even though my perception is just the crowds are getting whacker as we are getting older. It's like they don't dance as much. They don't do as much. They just sit there, do they dugging and keep it moving. I'm just... Everybody these days is trying to look the part, but not be the part. Like, you gotta go full force. You're gonna look the part, be the part. You know what I'm saying? Don't put on glasses if you can't know what 2 times 2 times 2 is. Duh, 8, nigga. How many of y'all sat there and tried to count that? So come get with me. Come check on me. More footage. A.E. Follow me on Twitter at A.E. Like my page, What's What and What Ain't. The Facebook page, I mean, this is where all the updates come from. You know where I am. We're about to do a voting. At the end of the semester, come mid-April, we're going to do a voting to see who had the best party of the year. Was it Blue Juice? Was it Hail to the Queen? Was it
KAOS?
You know what I'm saying? Like, we got to find this out, because I might have a surprise for the best part, the best group to throw a party. I got y'all something for next year. But I ain't going to tell y'all what. But I got y'all. Don't worry. This your boy A.E. I'm out. My bow tie, you see me.